Coordinated Restore Checkpoint, or CRaC for short, is an OpenJDK project aimed at reducing the startup and warm-up times of jar applications to mere milliseconds. In this video, I will show you how to use CRaC with Spring Boot applications running in a Docker container. To complete this tutorial, you need Docker, so make sure it is up and running. You also need an application based on Spring Boot 3.2 or later, because this version supports the CRaC project. We are going to use Spring Boot Pet Clinic, which is a reference application. You can get it on GitHub. We will also use Liberica Runtime Container with CRaC support. These images are freely accessible on Docker Hub, and they are tagged with a CRaC tag. Open the application in your favorite IDE. I'm using IntelliJ IDE. We don't have to change anything in this application. The only thing we need to do is to add the dependency for the CRaC project. I'm using Pet Clinic as a Maven project, and if you do too, go to the pom.xml file and add the following dependency. We will also need the following Docker file. Let's see what's going on here. On the first stage, we are using Liberica Runtime Container based on Liberica JDK Lite 21 and Alpaquita Linux with muscle support. This container also supports CRaC, as you see by the CRaC tag. At the first stage, we are not doing anything fancy, so that's business as usual. We copy our project into the image and package it into the jar file. On the second stage, we are using Liberica Runtime Container based on JRE, and what we are doing here is that we are using djarmod tools layers to create a layered jar, which is recommended by Spring. At the final stage, we copy all the resulting layers into the fresh image with Liberica JRE and Alpaquita Muscle and CRaC support, and we also use the following entry point. So here, we say that we want our application to exit as soon as it loads, and that we want to create a snapshot with the following command. We also use the jar launcher that knows how to work with layered jars. First of all, let's containerize our application with Docker build. Now let's run the application in a container. To create a checkpoint, we need two capabilities, cap checkpoint restore and system ptrace, which are enabled with the cap add flag. These capabilities are available with the Linux kernel version 5.9 and newer. But if you use a Linux distribution with an older kernel version, you can use the privileged flag instead of cap checkpoint restore and system ptrace. However, this is not the best practice to run containers with elevated permissions. As you can see, our application was checkpointed successfully, and here you can see the logs produced by the CRaC API. No worries, this is fine. So it's just the application is telling us what it was doing. Now let's create a fresh image with a checkpointed application. For that purpose, we will need Docker commit command. And here we are going to change the entry point to our image. So before, we specified that we want to checkpoint the application, and now we say that we want to restore the application from the snapshot. Now let's remove the previous container manually with docker-rm force, and now we can start the application by restoring it. We are specifying the port where our application is going to listen to, and we're also adding the checkpoint restore and system ptrace capabilities here. As you can see, the application started in milliseconds. It is also possible to start other Pet Clinic instances in separate containers. Just use another port on the host system and another container name. To verify that the application is working correctly, let's open it in the browser. As you can see, the application is running just fine. You can find the copy and paste code snippets for this tutorial in the dedicated guide. The link is in the description box below.